23. I lift up my eyes to you who are enthroned in heaven. I lift up my eyes to you who sit enthroned in heaven. Thank you. On a Monday morning, we can take our eyes off ourselves and lift them to you who sit enthroned in heaven.
And the more we see, the more
more we see, the more we love.
Sing with me how great is our God. The Lord has been revealed by
take me into your throne. Let me see your beauty. Let me see your face. Take me into your throne. Let me see your beauty. Let me see your face.
Thank you.
The King above, be the mountain where I run, mountain I drink from, for he is my son. The King above, be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life, for he is my son. You are. The King of be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves, oh, he is my son. The King of be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days, oh, he is my son. The you are good. You're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down. You're never.
Always, and you are good.
Good. Oh, and king of all. Either far inside my veins, the echo of my days, or he is my son. The king of all. Be the mountain where I run, the fountain where I drink from.
Christ.
Christ in me, the hope of glory. Be my everything. 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 Praise you.
Thank you.
here that I belong. Watching with us at the minute, I'd like to stay on for a few moments. Karen's going to come and lead us in some prayers now.
Well, good morning, and out of an hour worshipping with William, we're just going to pause before we head into the rest of our day on a Monday, the start of another week, and I'm going to lead you in some prayers together. So earlier this morning I was walking with the dogs along the cycle path near our house, and usually the grass between the cycle path and the canal towpath is mown short and left very tidy. And this morning as I walked towards it, I realised that it hadn't been cut probably for at least 2 or 3 weeks, and it looked really messy. And so as I was walking towards it thinking, oh, the council haven't been and it's looking a bit overgrown. But then as I began to walk through the path, I realised actually it wasn't messy, it was actually very beautiful. Because it had been left, it's full of wild flowers. Being one that knew my flowers, I began to look around and see how many I could name and count. And there was at least 10 different varieties of flowers that have blossomed simply because the grass had been left uncut. I was surprised, but it also made me ask a question about how do I see things? What is it that changes my perspective from walking along the path and thinking something looked a mess and overgrown and neglected, suddenly realised I was actually walking alongside something that was beautiful, full of colour, life and seeds, and actually really enjoyable. And as I came home and began just to think about that and think about praying this morning and praying with you, found myself reading back in Romans 8, verse 28, when it says, "We know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who've been called according to his purposes." So in the middle of everything, in this all things, God is working things out for our good. And just found myself asking the question, do I have eyes to see that? Or do I sometimes just see the mess or the way some things aren't working out? So I thought that would be a really helpful picture for us to hold in our minds as we just pray for a brief time together this morning. Whether we look at the uncut grass that the council haven't got round to cutting and see it as a mess, or do we have eyes to see beauty in something that's been left and even find ourselves surprised by what we see? So I'm going to lead us in some prayers and again pause and leave a few spaces to pray. We're going to pray for ourselves and also pray for others on this Monday morning. So let's pray together. Lord, thank you that in all things you are working for good. In the messiness and wildness of things, please help us to see what you see. In the uncut, the left alone, the overgrown, help us to discover beauty and see what you see. As we've already been singing this morning, Lord, help us to find you in the middle of our everything, in our working, our resting, our waking and sleeping, our laughing and weeping. In it all, on this Monday morning, we pray, Lord, help us to find you in the middle. It's the start of school holidays today. I'm sure there's been many a cheer from teachers and people working in education. It's still a challenging time for many. And so we'd pray this morning, Lord, for teachers, for those working in education. And we'd pray for them for rest and restoration over this summer. We pray for your blessing in their lives, Lord. Pray especially for head teachers and those with responsibility for decision making that have carried so much these last few weeks. Constantly changing policies being sent to them. Lord, we pray for them for rest and restoration. We pray for parents and carers who've been homeschooling and had children at home for months already. We pray for them today, for fresh grace, for peace over their homes, especially for those struggling, Lord. We pray this summertime that you would bless friendships, that you would bless family time. We pray for those who we know who have young children at home, or for teachers that are taking a break over summer. Let's pause and pray. Lord, we pray especially for young people that are finishing school or finishing college or university at the start of this summer. We pray for your help for them, Lord, when the future seems even more uncertain than usual. Pray you'd inspire them. Lord, pray they would be creative opportunities. Pray that even still you would help young people to chase their dreams. That you would lead and guide them, Lord. For those known to us, help us to be those still that can stand in the gap and pray. Pray peace over their lives this summertime. And we pray today for the communities we live in, Lord. And we pray that you would help us to walk well with you so that others would catch glimpses of you through our lives. So for a moment or two again, we pray for those who live alongside us, our neighbours, work colleagues, people that we'll walk alongside this week. Let's just pause and pray God's blessing on them today. We pray for the church today too. Lord, thank you that in these days, even through the challenges of COVID-19, you're growing your church. Thank you that you're strengthening us and working things for God. We pray, Lord, that you would help us to see the things that you want to stay the same, the things you want to deepen and grow in us. Help us to see the things that you are changing in and through us. Help us, Lord, to discover the new things that you have for us as we put our trust and our hope in you. Maybe you want to pray for the fellowship that you're involved with. Or pray out wider, even into the church in the nations today, that God would strengthen us. Lord, thank you that your eyes look even into the nations of the world to strengthen those who are fully committed to your ways. So we pray a strengthening of your church, not just for our local fellowship, but even into the nations of the world today, that in all things, as you are working for good, we pray you would strengthen your church, that she would shine brightly in these days. So on this Monday morning, Jesus, I pray that you would help us to live with eyes wide open, to see with your eyes, to live with hearts wide open, to receive your love and share it with others in the week ahead. We pray in Jesus' name. And Lord, as we pray together, we pray your blessing on each other. Pray that you would keep drawing us closer. And and to find you in the middle of it all. Thank you, Lord. Amen. So bless you today, and whatever your Monday holds, whatever the week ahead looks like for you, whether you're working, resting, busy doing different things, we pray blessing over you today, and hopefully connect with some of you in the week ahead. Bye for now.